Behind every digital circuit lies the logic, and these are expressed through logic gates. Now, these logic gates function on a concept of binary, which is 0 or 1. I can take a simple example of a bulb and I can say it is on or off. That means it is 0 or 1. Now, these are what are known as the Boolean logic gates after Boole. Now, these Boolean logic gates have very close similarity with symbolic logic, which we study in philosophy, the Western philosophy. And in the coming lectures, we would understand what is symbolic logic and the difference between a Boolean logic and a symbolic logic. To begin with, the Boolean logic, we say there are 7 common gates, which we would understand. The 3 are the basic gates, and, or, and not. Then with the combinations of these, we have further gates which are formed, for example, and, which is not plus and, nor, which is not plus or, so we also call it as nor. Then we have the zor and the xnor. So those are the various gates that we would understand. Coming on to the basis for the Boolean algebra. Boolean algebra, we begin with 0 or 1. When I say 1, the status is on, and when I say 0, the status is off. The voltage for either case, when it is 0, it is 0 volt. However, when we say it is 1, it is usually plus 5 volt that we consider. And with this, we would understand each of these examples as we move forward. So, Boolean algebra is the basis for the Boolean logic gates. And then we would have the combinations of these logic gates that we would understand further. To begin with, let's understand what is a buffer. Now, buffer is something which is very, very simple. Now, this is simply put in, and when we are putting an input of 1, it would get give an output of 1. When I'm putting an input of 0, it would give me an output of 0. What does this mean? I can simply explain this through a circuit diagram. So let me draw a circuit diagram here. I have a current flowing through this and going through the light emitting diode, which is located here. This is the symbol that we use for LED or the light emitting diode. And then I move forward and connect it to the input point with the transistor. So I have the base, collector and the emitter, and this emitter is connected to the ground. Now this collector I connect to the LED. Now as the current flows, what would happen? The current would flow here. Now as the current flow, when the input, this is my input, okay? So when my input is on, what would happen? The current would flow through the collector to the emitter and finally to the ground. And this is how I can say when the input is on, the LED would be on, and this is how I depict it. So with the LED, if I mark these two lines, it shows it is lighted or it is on. Okay, so this is how we depict a buffer. Now, coming on to the next closest one to buffer is a NOT. A very simple way, I have the same diagrammatic representation. I simply put a circle in front of it. And this circle is nothing but what is known as inverse bubble or inversion bubble. So we call this as inversion bubble. And the function of this inversion bubble is it would invert the signal. So this NOT gate functions in the inverter. That means if it is on, if it is 1, the output would be 0. If the input is 0, the output would be 1. How? We would understand that in a while with a circuit diagram. But in Boolean algebra, how do we represent the output of a NOT gate? The output of the NOT gate is represented, if the input is A, the output would be either A bar or what we call as A slash. So either of those are the output representing the same thing, which is NOT. Okay, now let's draw the circuit diagram for the same. I have 5 volts connected here. Through the resistor, I have the current passing here. Now here, what I do is I connect the LED. So I connect the LED here, and I also connect the transistor in parallel. Now here is my base, collector, emitter, and this is the ground. So what I do is I connect this here. Okay, now what is the possibility? As the current passes here, Now current has an option to either go this way or to follow the path of the transistor. Now if my input is on, what would happen? My input is on, then the current would flow through the collector to the emitter and finally to the ground, and it would follow the path of least resistance, and therefore if the input is on, my LED would be off. Now let's take another example. So in the another example, what I have is, I have again the 5 volt, I have the resistance which is connected here. Okay, now I have the LED, and then what I do is, I have the collector, the base and the emitter of the transistor, and then finally grounded. Okay, so this is how I draw it. Now what would happen? As the current passes here, the current has an option to go either ways, but since my input is off, okay, my input is off, what would happen? The current would follow this path and the LED would be on. And therefore, if this is 0, input is 0, my output would be 1. So if my input is 0, my output is 1. However, my input when it was 1, the output would be 0. And this is what is NOT gate. Now, NOT gate basically are a simple inversion, and therefore are the basic principle which is used in the inverter. The next is AND. In the Boolean logic, AND is very, very important. AND means the event can happen when both of them are present. So I take various combinations, but I'll draw the combinations later on. I'll first draw the circuit to help you understand better. Now note, in this, so far we were considering just one input and one output. Here in AND OR, we would have two or more than two input, but the output would be one. So let's first begin with two input. We would then talk about three input as well. So first we talk with two input. So I draw the circuit diagram. I have 5 volts connected here, and then I connect an LED. Now as I move forward with the LED, I connect the two transistors through the two input. So this is the first input that I connect. Then I link this input to another input, which is another transistor. Okay, and then finally this transistor is grounded, and this transistor is connected to the first one. Now this is what is AND. What I do is, I start with passing the current here. Now in which scenario the current would pass? This is the base, collector and the emitter, and again the base, collector and the emitter for the second transistor. So if this is on and this is on, both of them are on, only then my current can move through the ground. So if I have input as 1, input A, so this is A and this is B. So input A as 1 and input B as 1. That means both of them, when they are in the on state, my output would be 1. If either of them is on, or if either of them is on, then the current won't reach the ground. So if I say this is off, for example, if this is off and this is on, then the circuit won't complete, so this won't be feasible. Or if I say this is on and this is off, then again the circuit won't complete and reach the ground. Or if both are off, then again the circuit won't complete. So in either of these cases, what would be the scenario? My output would turn to be 0. My output would be 1 only when both the inputs are on. And therefore, this is the only condition in which output would yield 1. Now, in AND, we represent this by a dot. So, I can simply write AB together or A dot B. So, that's the representation for AND in Boolean logic. Now, understand the symbologies very, very carefully. The symbologies for Boolean are a little different from that of the symbologic, the symbolic logic. Okay, so here we have the dot. Now I repeat again, the AND gate is an electronic circuit that gives high output only if all the inputs are high. So only if both of them are 1, only and only in that case you would have output as 1. Now, what if I connect a third one here? Rather than 2 inputs, I take 3 inputs. So rather than just having A, B, I take A, B and C. The result would be 1 only and only if all 3 of them are turned on. If a single of them is off, then the result cannot be on. So if there are more than 1, then again the same principle will work, and the AND gates are connected in series, as you have seen here. So one transistor and then next transistor connected in series, and that's the most important thing. AND gates connected in series and coming on to OR gate. OR gates are connected in parallel. Now I have already given you the hint, so let me draw the circuit diagram. I have 5 volt here, the current passing through this, and then you have the LED connected, here, and then there are 2 transistors which are connected. So here is the first input, and then here is the second input, okay, and these 2 together are connected to the ground. Now when the current pass, so current would pass here, current can either pass through case A, okay, current can either pass through case B. If both of them are on, the current would distribute through both of them. There can be only one case where the current would not pass, when both of them are off. Since they are connected in parallel, either of them, if it is on, the current would allow them to pass. So only if both of them are off, the current cannot pass. If A is on and B is off, the current would pass. If A is off and B is on, again the current would pass. And definitely if both of them are on, the current would pass. And this is what is the OR gate. Now OR gate is represented as, in Boolean logic, A plus B. So plus is the sign which we use to represent OR gate. Remember again, OR gates are connected in parallel, and this is the symbology that we use for OR gate. The symbology for AND gate is a straight line that we have seen in the previous section. So just coming back to the AND gate again, so this is the symbology for the AND gate. Coming on to the combinations now, NOR is nothing but a combination of OR and NOT. So I do a simple combination of NOT and OR. So what I do is, I take the inputs here. What are my inputs? My inputs are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and then I have 1 and 1. So in this case, first I send the current through OR. Okay, so I have this as OR, and then I connect a NOT to it. So A and B, I send a signal A plus B, and then I have A plus B NOT. So first I would find A plus B, which is OR. So what is my OR? 0, 1, 1 and 1. And what is the NOT for it? 1, 0, 0 and 0. So this is how you represent the NOR. It is a combination of OR and NOT. Only and only if the values are low, the output would be high. So as you can see, if the values are low, both the values are low, here, so A and B are 0, then only my output would be 1, and that is the NOR gate. The next is the NAND gate. Now NAND gate, what happens is, I am combining AND and NOT. So A and B, so current would flow through this AND gate, and it would be A and B, and then A and B NOT. That's how we represent it. So first of all, I would find the AND for it, AB. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Only in one condition, when both of them are on, the current would pass. So I would have 1 here only, and the rest all would be 0. Now NAND. So I connect a NOT. So what is 0 would become 1, what is 1 would become 0, as simple as that. So this would be 1, 1, 1 and 0. That means only and only when the input, both the inputs are high, my output would be low. So I have high input 1 and 1, and that's the only case where I have 0 as the output. So when both the inputs, I can write it as, when both the inputs are high, my output would be low. And that is what is the NAND gate. So these are how we have understood the Boolean logic gates, and or not, the three basic ones, and then the combination of these, which is the NAND and the NOR. The idea is these Boolean logic have a close similarity with the symbolic logic. The Boolean logics are mainly used with computer science digital circuits, where the results can be absolutely either 1 or 0, and they cannot be applied to the real world settings. When I need to apply those to the real world settings where you have possibilities, we need to understand the symbolic logic, which we would discuss in the next section, and then we would also compare and contrast what is a Boolean logic and a symbolic logic.